I was on my way to New York to film another budget episode for the awesome vlog and saw the news of a new update of Final Cut Pro. So I gave myself a challenge. Learn to use the magnetic mask and see if it works as Apple advertised, and maybe just make a video out of it. I'm gonna try and make a few seconds with the new masking tool from Final Cut Pro and see how it works. But this time around, I'm also gonna show you how I did it. This is that video. So the new magnetic mask can be found under the Effects tab, bottom right. But let's start from the beginning. You have a clip, and it's color corrected as you wanted, and the right size. You go to the wand icon and tap on Enhance Light and Color. Here are some benefits of having AI do some color grading by itself. First with the effects, and without effects. Now we can make a copy of this clip, and we are going to apply the magnetic mask on. You drag and drop the mask, and because it is magnetic, it detects the human in the video. Remember, the mask only shows the thing that is masking. If you select the human, that is going to be the one that's going to be on top. If you have to make some small adjustments manually, just tap on the plus or the minus and correct what the mask didn't get right. Tap on Analyze, and Final Cut Pro tracks the movement in the entirety of the clip, front and back. Don't forget to tap Done. Then just add the title between the mask and the video, and you are done. I've sped up this part just so we don't waste any time. Now you can play around with this quite alright, because you can add LUTs and effects to the mask itself or to the background. Here's an example how I played around with these, and I think it's quite powerful if it gets the mask right. But here is actually the key. If you give it different objects except humans, in what I could test, you're gonna find it a bit harder for the masking to work. Let me give you an example. This bubbles video. This is sped up, of course. We're not gonna waste time here, but a lot of editing had to go into it because Final Cut Pro didn't understand where each bubble went. But this might not be the right example, because for me to be able to create content really fast, this function is absolutely magic. So let's do another recap of how this works. You put a copy of the original video on top so that you can put a mask, a magnetic mask, on the object you want isolated. You drag the magnetic mask on top of the human, like so, and that's all you need to do. Once this is done, you click on Analyze. As you see, it tracks the entire movement of the subject. That is the magic part. Don't forget to click Done. Then you just add the title between the mask and the original clip, and you are ready to go. The last test I wanted to put this through is, let's say it's a sandwich that we have here. The object recognition, is it any good to understand it's still a sandwich when I move the camera? And as it turns out, it can. I'm moving the camera around the sandwich, and it knows to assign the mask to it. In general, these videos about Final Cut Pro have never been so popular for my channel. If you've made it to the end, you can also take a look at the Final Cut Pro voice isolation functionality where I tested it this summer. You might like it. Victor, out.